constitutions are not made for the angels we know, but for both the angels and devils we don't know. So in crafting a constitution, we don't have to look at who is the president. We don't have to look at
constitution on the principle of separation of powers. The shameless action signifies the rebirth of the legacy of the Lancaster House Constitution, amended 20 times and once allowed to open a floodgate of many amendments to the Constitution by the government of Zimbabwe. We have evidence and reason to believe that the proposed bill is one of the clauses that were rejected during the constitution-making process in 2012 regarding the executive appointments. In the face of impending elections in 2018, the amendment strengthens the establishment of competitive authoritarianism and marks an end to the principle of separation of powers. As the judicial arm becomes subjected to presidential control reminiscent of the Lancaster House Constitution, the bill is meant to compromise the independence of the judiciary. The amendment also undermines all the current efforts to promote constitutionalism in Zimbabwe. 2 months shy to the fourth anniversary of the Supreme document, the same government, which has been slow in aligning the laws, is in a hurry to amend it. We hold the view that the intention to amend the constitution is aimed at advancing the parochial ZANU-PF succession agenda. The amendment is unacceptable. It is a political sham aimed at overriding the popular, transparent and democratic process which put in place the legal document in 2013. It is our view that the articulated process in the Constitution of appointing the Chief Justice allows a democratic process of selecting shortlisted competent candidates from the Judicial Services Commission on merit, whereas the proposed amendment gives the President the power to solely select and appoint.
Constitution and realigning the 43 remaining laws according to the Constitution, because if you check, we have independent commissions that were formed in 2013. Up until now, the National Peace and Reconciliation Commission hasn't fully been operational, yet we are getting into elections where issues of national healing, reconciliation and national healing reconciliation have not been addressed.
It's a very sensitive year because it comes just a few months before the general elections next year, and this makes it a very contentious issue why the government intends to amend the constitution at this hour. Then secondly is actually the issue on the rationale that the government gave, which they say triggers the amendment process. We have realized that what it means is that the government business has now become subservient to the chaos within ZANU-PF that is partisan and factional in nature. Then lastly, the issue of the implications of this amendment. We also raise it because we know that the current Minister of Justice, under whose ministry this amendment is being pushed, also doubles as the Vice President of ZANU-PF and that of the state. And we all know of his well-documented aspirations to succeed the current president. Even Marx, even people in Mapanzure, they all know of his interests in the top post. So these are some of the questions which the citizenry is raising with regards to this proposed amendment. I will now give colleagues the floor if there are issues to do with clarifications, additions and so forth. Over to you, colleagues.